Question number 61. Azure PowerShell script and command line interface, CLI script, are entirely compatible with each other. Option A, true. Option B, false. The correct answer is option B, false. Azure PowerShell and Azure CLI use different syntaxes and command structures. PowerShell uses commandlets while CLI uses commands. They are not directly interchangeable. Question number 62. If your feature is in the general availability phase, then your feature will receive support from all Microsoft support channels. Option A, true. Option B, false. The correct answer is option A, true. In the general availability GA phase, a feature is fully released and supported across all Microsoft support channels, including standard technical support, documentation, and service level agreements, SLAs. Question number 63. What happens if Azure does not meet its own service level agreement guarantee, SLA? Option A, it's not possible. Azure will always meet its SLA. Option B, you will be financially refunded a small amount of your monthly fee. Option C, the service will be free that month. The correct answer is option B, you will be financially refunded a small amount of your monthly fee. If Azure fails to meet its service level agreement, SLA guarantee, customers may receive a service credit, which is a small percentage of their monthly fee, depending on the severity of the outage. However, Azure does not offer full refund or free service for the entire month. Question number 64. What operating system does an Azure virtual machine support? Option A, Linux. Option B, Windows. Option C, Windows, Linux, and Mac OS. Option D, Mac OS. Option E, Windows and Linux. The correct answer is option E, Windows and Linux. Azure virtual machines support both Windows and Linux operating systems. Mac OS is not supported as a VM OS in Azure. Question number 65. Which of the following resources are not considered compute resources? Option A, Azure batch. Option B, virtual machines. Option C, virtual machine scale sets. Option D, load balancer. Option E, function apps. The correct answer is option D, load balancer. Azure load balancer is not a compute resource because it only distributes network traffic rather than performing computing tasks. The other options involve processing power and are considered compute resources. Just a quick reminder. If you don't want to watch all these videos and instead download all questions and answers, then feel free to purchase them on Buy Me a Coffee page. I have shared the link below. Question number 66. Where can you go to see what standard Microsoft is in compliance with? Option A, Azure Service Health. Option B, Azure Security Center. Option C, Azure Privacy Base. Option D, Trust Center. The correct answer is Option D, Trust Center. The Azure Trust Center provides information on the standards, compliance certification, and regulations Microsoft Azure adheres to, including GDPR, ISO certifications, and more. Question number 67. How many minutes per month downtime is 99.99% availability? Option A, 4. Option B, 40. Option C, 100. Option D, 1. The correct answer is Option A, 4. With 99.99% availability, the maximum allowable downtime per month is approximately 4 minutes. This is calculated by taking 0.01% of a 30-day month, which results in about 4 minutes of downtime. Question number 68. How do you stop your Azure account from incurring cost above a certain level without your knowledge? Option A, set up a billing alert to send you an email when it reaches a certain level. Option B, only use Azure function which have a significant free limit. Option C, switch to Azure Reserve instances with hybrid benefit for VMS. Option D, implement the Azure spending limit in the account center. The correct answer is Option A, set up a billing alert to send you an email when it reaches a certain level. You can set up billing alerts in the Azure portal to notify you when your spending reaches a specific threshold. This helps you monitor your usage and avoid unexpected costs. Options like spending limits are only available for Azure free accounts. Question number 69. If you have an Azure free account with a $200 credit for the first month, what happens when you reach the $200 limit? Option A, all services are stopped and you must decide whether you want to convert to a paid account or not. Option B, your account is automatically closed. Option C, your credit card is automatically billed. Option D, you cannot create any more resources until you add more credit to the account. The correct answer is Option A, all services are stopped and you must decide whether you want to convert to a paid account or not. When you reach the $200 credit limit on an Azure free account, your services are stopped. You then have the option to either convert your account to pay-as-you-go plan or stop using Azure services. You are not automatically billed unless you choose to upgrade to a paid account. Question number 70. What is the significance of the Azure region? Why is it important? Option A, even though you have to choose a region when creating resources, there is generally no consequence of what you select. You can create a network in one region and then create virtual machines for that network in another region. Option B. Region is just a folder structure in which you organize resources, much like file folders on a computer. Option C. Once you select a region, you cannot create resources out of that region. So selecting the right region is an important decision. Option D. You must select a region when creating most resources, and the region is the area of the world where those resources will be physically located. The correct answer is option D. You must select a region when creating most resources, and the region is the area of the world where those resources will be physically located. The Azure region refers to a specific geographic location where your resources will be hosted. It is important because it determines the physical location of your data, affects latency, and ensures compliance with data residency regulations. Additionally, regions are often associated with certain availability and reliability features that can influence performance and disaster recovery strategies.